You got to do the clap just so it can sync up. That's the whole thing about doing this shit.
Oh, we're live?
We're live.
Oh,
we're
okay.
Live.
Yeah, go ahead. All right. Glad, live. Glad I didn't say nothing.
Hey, shit. Welcome, everybody. Welcome, everybody, to another edition of Support the Homie Podcast. I am your homie, Chris the Lightskin Legend.
D-Money Fresh, the other homie.
And we in this motherfucker one more time. Season two.
Season two.
I know it. We know we took some time off. You know what I'm saying? Motherfuckers had some real life shit going on. You know what I'm saying? Motherfuckers had real life shit going on. But we here. We back, man. Season two, episode 23.
Oh, we some kind of episode?
22? 23.
We're not going to start over? Episode
no,
one?
No, we're just going I want to keep the number thing going.
Keep the number thing. Right.
We are season two because we took a little vacation.
Okay. Episode 23.
So it's episode 23 because we're just going to keep this motherfucker rolling. Shit, man, how you been, man? Where you been?
Rolling like Bart. Man, shit, at the house, where you been at? Been recovering, where you been at?
Well, you know, just same old shit, working, you know what I mean?
I mean, you know, you don't check in with me every time I look up.
I mean,
you got a Raider game or something?
Yeah, you know, I got to see my boys play, 4-2.
Yeah.
4-2,
you guys should definitely be 2-4.
No, that's easy. A few plays here, a few plays there. Of
2-4.
Of course. I mean, that's any team can say that. Your team can say that.
No, we can't.
Your team can say that.
Yeah, we should be 6-0.
No. Fuck no.
Yeah, we should be 6-0.
Fuck no, man. Y'all should have lost. Y'all should have lost to motherfucking New England.
No, we shouldn't.
Oh, yeah. Y'all should have lost to New England.
How?
But we ain't going to talk about that. Hey, we ain't going to talk about We ain't going to talk about how Mac Jones is playing pretty damn good.
He is playing good. What do I got to do with us?
I don't give a fuck what he got to do with y'all. But it fits their fucking.
Yeah, Mac Jones. He's playing better than Derek Carr.
Oh, God. Derek Carr is the MVP candidate this year.
Come on,
say
man.
I'm lying. Say you know I'm what? Lying.
Since we took time apart, I still. Nah, I think you back smoking dope. Back smoking.
Say I'm lying.
Yeah,
you
come on,
you fucking know. I'm
the
not.
Reason why y'all be losing is because it's play.
No, bro.
Stop it.
Get out of here, bro.
Derek Carr, he be looking so shaky. I guarantee y'all make playoffs.
Wait, what?
Y'all not making playoffs.
We are making the playoffs. What are you talking about?
You guys are not making playoffs.
Right now, we're tied AFC West.
I don't care what you're telling me right now. You guys are not making playoffs.
What are you talking about?
Make a bet that you guys make playoffs.
We're going to make the playoffs. Hey, Raider fans, man, we making the playoffs this year, man. All you haters out there, we making the playoffs this year. Raiders going to make a fucking playoffs.
You know what? Y'all might because y'all got rid of the racist shit. And now
y'all lost.
He lost the locker room. Now motherfuckers want to play.
Is John Gruden racist? React.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
And I'm not defending. I'm not defending.
You are defending him.
I'm not defending.
You're like Tim Brown right now.
Nah, man. He just.
That's Tim Brown. You don't fuck if you go on radio and say he's not racist. I'm like, nigga. Okay.
No, right. That was the thing. Like, it's like, bro, you can't.
Everybody, he masked it. He disguised it.
I will say that.
Okay. So he's racist.
I don't think he's racist, though. I don't think
you
he's
just
racist.
Say, yeah. On one breath and air saying.
I think what happened was this.
What happened?
He made some insensitive comments. True, he made some racist comments. True.
Okay.
Does that necessarily make you a racist?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. All right. Now I'll say this though, for the dude to the mask is right though. I ain't gonna lie to you, man. The dude said he must have felt like this for years, all his life. Okay, let me give you some.
It off.
Let me give you some examples though. This is the crazy shit. You know, you start looking back at shit. And I started going on Twitter and people start posting shit. Right? He cut the remember the punter, our black punter we had.
King. Yeah.
King, right? Mm. Okay, Marquette King, right? Trades Cooper. What's his first name?
Amari.
Okay. Trades Khalil Mack. What's his first name? Khalil. He got rid of all the brothers. He was getting rid of all the brothers.
And y'all didn't draft shit.
None of them. Shit.
I can't even remember who the fuck y'all draft besides Jacobs.
Nobody really. It's just Jacobs, I think, out of that.
Nobody panned
out.
Out of six picks.
Out of that package.
Nobody panned out.
Because Arnett looking like. He just looking like he don't belong.
That nigga need to go. He need to go play in the Europe League or something.
Like he looking like a third, fourth round type pick. Like you just kind of like take a shot on. But they drafted him first. I was trying to get a boy some credit. I was trying to give him some bail. Maybe he'll be something, but no. He ain't nothing. He ain't really nothing.
Put it like this though. Even if John wasn't racist, I don't have racist by my body. Yeah, motherfucker, that sound right.
Right.
You checked every box.
Hey.
Because let's put everything in full blown perspective.
All right.
The racist shit came out. He's still coaching.
Yep.
Nobody cared about that.
Yep.
Nobody cared about that.
I know where you're going. Go ahead.
The gay stuff came out and the sexist shit came out.
Mm.
And now he doesn't have a job.
Talk about that.
I looked at things like, oh, that's the world that we live. That's the United States that we live in.
Yeah, you can't. You can't.
Because, I can call you a nigger.
Yeah.
And man, have all these jokes. Still have my job.
Interesting.
I guarantee he lost the locker room with that first comment.
Yeah.
I guarantee he did.
Yeah.
Like Drew Brees said that bullshit, two years ago. Nobody wanted the Saints, was just a terrible team after
that. Right.
But he says the racial comment, still has a job. The sexist come out, the homophobic comment come out. Interesting. Now he's gone.
Yeah. You can't offend that community.
No, you can't at all.
I'm not even going to say it's cancel culture because he canceled himself. It's not.
He canceled
himself.
Yeah, he canceled himself.
But you can't offend the LGBTQ+ community, bro, because they get after you. You lose shit
And in a nutshell, I know, like, their number one enemy, Dave Chappelle. I'm going to go see Dave Chappelle, actually, things that we've been up to. I'm going to go see Dave Chappelle, right?
I want to see him, too.
He does a great show.
Yeah.
And he broke down. I was just like, just because you're gay, does that mean you're not racist?
Okay.
No, that's a question.
No, right.
You know what I'm saying?
No, right.
Y'all got more rights than anybody.
Okay.
More than us.
Okay.
More, like, come on now.
Okay.
So just because you're gay, which I really don't care what you are.
Right.
But does that mean you're not racist? Does that mean you don't watch the news like, these niggas are crazy?
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Because
forget what you like and what you're humping.
That's orientation. That's sexual orientation.
Forget your sexual orientation. No,
okay, yeah.
That means you can't be racist?
Right, no, you can. Yeah, you can. But here's the thing, too. At the same time, man, you know, okay, let's talk about Dave Chappelle's special then. Like this last one, when he talked about the one transgender that stood up for him.
Right.
You know, and then the LGBT community, like, shunned him.
Right, that was his friend. She was in the Bay Area, right.
And then end up committing suicide.
Right.
And y'all shun? You know what I'm saying? Like, what
that was one
doing?
Of y'all.
Yeah, that was one of, right, what are we doing here? You know what I'm saying? Just because you support Dave Chappelle and, because listen, I can't tell anybody, you know, if you're with the transgender community, I can't tell you how to feel. I can't tell you if that was homophobic or transphobic.
Right.
What he was talking about. I can't tell you how to feel. I can't tell you to be offended or not to be offended. You know, me hearing the comments, I was just like, it didn't sound transphobic. It sounded like, you know, but here's my thing. Why can't y'all get these jokes? Y'all want to be treated equal, right?
It's true.
Y'all want to be treated equal, right?
That's a good point.
Get these jokes too. Like, everybody gets these jokes.
Every race has jokes.
John Gruden, if he was a stand-up comedian, he's giving out, he like you said, he checked every box. He was giving it to everybody. Except, I don't think he didn't hit the Mexicans though. No.
Racial. You gave him 10 more emails. I guarantee you probably would have touched that.
Hey, but why? Here's the thing. This is what pisses me off though the most. Why is it only him going down for this?
That's nothing.
Who was he? Like, somebody had to respond to some of those emails, right? Correct.
It was the GM. It was
Allen. Bruce Allen.
Bruce Allen for the Redskins.
I remember Bruce.
So they have it on hush what he said back.
Right, and then you see how the NFL tried to come out and say, "Oh, we didn't find any other
come on out. Like,
out of 65,000 emails, get the fuck out of here."
And then y'all went looking for some shit. Y'all didn't even find what the fuck y'all was looking for.
Y'all investigating the Redskins' toxic culture.
They talking about. I think it was like sexual harassment.
But again, the Redskins. I'm sorry, Washington football team.
Whatever.
But they were investigating their toxic culture, so, you know, and Gruden gets the axe.
You know what's funny is because hey, the football team, they could be doing whatever they want to be doing. It could have been a hostile, sexual environment.
They was nasty.
But they don't type it. There you go. That's the difference between them and Gruden. They don't type it.
You got to be smart.
Don't I'm not condoning what you're doing.
Right, yeah. I'm not saying it's right.
But if you're going to do it right.
Listen, let's be honest, man. The only reason why he's in trouble, because he put it in writing. Yeah, he put it in writing. If you would have just, later in the day, hey, man, I'm going to hit you up later. I'm going to call you. Tell him on the phone or... Hey, I'm going to pull you to the side. Hey, let's go outside and talk real quick. I got something to tell you. Get all your shit off. You can.
Nigga, I'm acting like Robert De Niro and Joe Pesci in Casino. Oh, we going in the car. We turning it on. I'm turning the radio on, the AC.
Right.
Asking you put your phone in the house, everything.
Right.
Now I'm going to get off what I got to say. At the same time, he brought up with the female refereeing. I didn't have a problem with that necessarily. All you gotta do is teach somebody how to do it, whether it's a dog or whatever the case might be. I'm being dramatic when I say a dog, But I mean, I don't understand what his problem was with that. Listen, you're a real life sexist.
But yeah, what, see, he's everything. Yeah. He's everything. He's everything. He's an equal opportunity offender, bro. He's going to offend. He offended everybody.
And when he called, I think he called Roger Goodell a faggot, right?
Call him the F word. I guess we got to say the F word. We can't say faggot. Me. We got to say F word.
Excuse me, the F word. I don't even think he meant him like in a gay term. It's a gay term.
Yeah,
he was just slandering him.
Yeah, there's a difference between
because
if Goodell is gay and then he says that, that's a slur.
Yeah, there you go.
But let's be honest, bro.
That's like sitting here, you call me a cracker, and I'm like, bro, I'm not white.
Right, like, why are you calling me that?
I'm not offended by that, you know what I mean?
Right, exactly. So,
but that's not how people not going
to
look at it.
No, they don't look at it that way, and they're not going to. And that's what, and then we're here now, and this is what we get, man. We get.
Well, y'all play better without the motherfucker, so we'll see.
So was the play calling better?
Yeah, 30-something points.
I just say, you know, they execute it. Like people can be weak with that.
Play calling was better.
Okay, let me say this though. Let me just say this.
Yeah, go ahead.
Fucking, that game could have went either way, right?
Mm-hmm.
Bridgewater overthrew some motherfuckers. He missed some throws, and they were running wide open. That was on money. That's a touchdown. I saw about two or three touchdowns.
You got secondary suspect as hell. But.
Yeah, hey, the OG. Hayward?
He's 90 overall, man.
They had to boost the shit up because, hey, bro, he ain't gave up a touchdown yet. Now he would have if Teddy would have threw one on the money.
And that's why Teddy's 78 overall.
there you go. Yeah, man. So John Gruden out. Insensitive comments.
Hey, so is he still owner? Like, he have some ownership or something?
No, he never had ownership. He just had that big ass contract.
So is that voided since he resigned?
I think he's going to get some lawyers involved. I know I would to get the last, 6 years? 6 years? Yeah, bro, you're not about to void $60 million. No. We're going to talk
about
a buyout.
You resigned. A buyout?
We're talking about a buyout. If I'm him,
we're talking about a buyout. Yeah, it's cheaper to have some motherfuckers in your house.
Yeah, yeah.
So a buyout.
Hey, we're talking about a buyout, bro.
You resigned.
No. I got forced out. That was a hit job.
No, that wasn't forced out. I didn't force you out.
That was a hit job.
I didn't force shit out.
Okay, so. You're Gruden.
Mm-hmm.
You go to the meeting. Oh, no, fuck it.
I'm Mark.
You be Mark.
I'm Mark.
Boom. You go. You got to meet. You the owner. You got to meet him. You know this. Boom. We have our meeting. We're sitting down talking. You know damn well Gruden just said, okay, I'm going to just walk away. I'm going to just resign. You know he didn't say that. But you know the pressure. So Mark was like, hey, bro, this is a lot of heat.
That's not what Mark
said.
That's
a lot of heat.
Mark said you got to ask the NFL while he resigned.
Right. Exactly. Exactly. But we know, we all know it's a hit job.
Well, if I don't fire you, you resigned, right? I don't care what you're telling me.
No, but we all know. Okay. You're saying the correct way.
Can you collect unemployment if you quit your job?
No.
No. You resign. That's quitting.
Yeah, but he didn't resign. That's what I'm trying to tell you.
What are you talking about?
We all know what happened.
You want to bring us to John Gruden resigns?
Dude, no. We know what it says.
John Gruden
But we know what happened. You know that was a hit job. So he had to, I got to save face. Okay, yeah. So you just step down, bro.
I'm not paying you. We're not discussing a buyout because you.
You respect him.
You should do what you did. Respect what?
You respect, because you're Mark Davis right now.
Yeah,
so,
respect
you respect him.
No, I don't.
Yeah, you don't?
No.
I think you do.
Yeah, one Super Bowl. I don't respect that. With Tony Dungy's team. I mean,
he sure did. Sure did.
Tony Dungy's team.
He's overrated. He's overrated.
He's hella big overrated.
Think about this.
If you look at his overall record, he's like 500 or
right.
under 500.
Look at it like this, right? When he had Gannon, he was, you know, he had a, that was a perfect journeyman for him, right?
Mm-hmm.
Turned him into a little MVP, all the shit. I'm not going to say little because that was MVP season, right? Had a good run, right? They go over there to Tampa Bay. They got a defense. They just need a little help on that offensive side. Boop. Okay, got Brad Johnson. All right, just don't fuck it up for me. Win the shit. After that,
downhill.
I remember, he tried to go get so-and-so out of retirement. He used to play quarterback for the Broncos.
I know he's about Greasy.
No. Fuck. Forgot his name.
Jake Plummer.
Plummer. He was called Plummer. Bruh. Always chasing a quarterback, bruh. He was always chasing a quarterback until he got Carr.
You were Keyshawn Johnson said?
Call him a fraud.
Yeah.
Call him a fraud. What do you think? I said, look, that's his experience with him. They had beef when there was in
I think it was a lot of cats that had beef with John, though.
All black?
Yeah. Wasn't Brad Johnson.
he might be a racist.
Might be, huh?
Might be. We got some evidence. We got evidence.
Out of 10 minutes, you think he might be a fucking racist?
He might be a racist. I don't know.
Ain't no Mike. That nigga is racist.
He might be a racist, bro. All right, man. Let's get off of John Gruden. We done with John, man. To get on some different news, man. Let's get on your boy since we're talking about some transgenders and we're talking about the Dave Chappelle special. We talking about John insulting all the transgenders.
Who's my boy?
Your boy, man, from Family Matters, man. What's his name? Darius McCary? What's his name?
No, McQuarrie.
McQuarrie? Yeah.
What about him?
He dating a transgender, is it woman? So, because when you
identify as women now.
Yeah, so right. So that's a, right? Dating openly. Love.
Yeah.
You got any comments?
No, not really.
Are you going to be safe? We're going to play, let's be safe.
No, I mean, first of all, this is going on record. Family Matters was trash to me. I never liked it. It was garbage.
Oh, love Family Matters, bro.
That's not even top five in the 90s.
I don't give a damn if it's top five. It don't have to be top five. It's not even top 10.
I ain't like it.
Why?
It sucked to me. I ain't like it. I don't even fuck about Laura and Carl and that shit.
You didn't like none of that shit? That shit was corny. Decent. It got corny when Erica turned into Stefan.
That was corny too.
Nah, that's when it got corny. It had to, like, they had to do, they were trying to mix it up.
There's a gay rumor about Carl Winslow, too. The dad?
Oh, no, he was. I think he was gay. Is he dead or alive?
I don't know.
But I think he is gay. I think he is gay.
There's a whole bunch of shit going on that set.
Yeah. Nah, it's a lot of shit. There's a lot of shit.
I mean, that's what you're into. That's what you're into.
Yeah, let people be gay, man. You know, we don't have a problem with people being gay.
My whole thing is don't be hiding it. Like, you know what I mean? Like,
right. Well, see, that's another thing. Like, a lot of people don't come out. Because think about back in the day when you came out, there were people really like bashing, gay bashing.
Right, right.
So I understand when it takes some time for people to come out. Like Nassib, Carl Nassib coming out.
I don't care what your orientation is, right? This is my whole thing.
All
right, either you're gay, straight, or you're celibate, whatever you are, right?
Right.
I don't need to announce I'm a straight man.
Okay.
So like when people be like, "Oh, I'm gay,"
and you're like.
Bro, who cares? Like, why, bro, like, what? Why are you what's telling up? This? I'm still saying, like, I'm still going to speak to you.
Right, yeah, like.
Why are you telling me this?
All just my, because you attention. Take dick in the butt, I mean, that doesn't change our relationship.
You want attention, and that's annoying to me. You want attention.
And
keep it solid. Bro, anybody that plays sports, especially football, because there's so many of us.
Yeah.
Bro, we know who's gay and who's not.
Okay, I see what you're saying.
Steve, come on, I'm gay. Nigga, we knew that. What are you talking about?
Bruh, you didn't have to.
We know who's gay, who's not.
Right.
That's not going to change, bro. I'm telling you, good job. I'm going to slap you on your butt, whatever. Good job, whatever.
Is that gay?
If
you slap somebody on the butt that's gay, that plays football with you, that's gay, dude.
That's
that make
a football
you,
gesture.
Does
so
that make
I'm
gonna
go,
gay
I'm
going
to go with no.
Okay.
I probably wouldn't openly do it, but.
I'm going to hit him on the shoulder.
Yeah.
Shoulder pad.
Whatever
case,
you're still going to be one of the homies, man. Like,
right. I feel you on
you
that.
Don't need to come out and make a fucking news conference that you're gay and everything. Like, bro, we knew that.
Yeah,
Steve,
I'm 100% with
NASA,
you on that.
They knew that.
Yeah, you know, I was listening to Charlamagne Tha God, and like one of his assistants used to go to school with him. She was like, oh, yeah, we kind of figured that. And I was like, damn, even she knew. Like,
the girl knew?
Oh, well, you know.
Everybody knew.
You know, they got gaydar, so.
Me too.
You know what I mean? And so, yeah, so there's that. But yeah, man, he's dating a transgender openly. And here's the thing, right? Like you were just saying, who gives a damn, man? That's what you like. That's what you like. But remember Malik Yoba? No, he liked him too. I think he's married, but I think he liked transgender women. So that's because that's man turning into woman, right? Transgender. Yeah, so I think he likes him too. So it's just like, okay, bro.
He got caught with one?
Yeah, he got caught with one. But now it's just like, I think he might have finally owned it. It was like, yeah, you know, I just like him. Good, bro. That's what I'm saying. Like, what you do in the bed don't make me come.
So let me ask you this. So you'd be like, so are they just, so if you dating a transgender, is that gay then you just dating a regular man?
Wait. No. I'm trying to follow.
A regular man and a transgender.
A regular man and a transgender.
Like a dude that's just gay. He's
not trans. There's a dude that's just gay. But he still dresses up like a man.
Yeah.
And then you got the transgender.
Yeah.
I don't want to call them trainees. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Because appearance, does that matter? Does that make it, like, what does that do? Does that make it even more cool?
I'm a bro, if you're gay, you're gay. I mean, whether the motherfucker here cross dressing or
right,
not.
Right. Yeah. Just because the motherfucker got a dress on but still pulled a dick out on you. You know what I'm saying? The motherfucker put a dick out and draw down on you.
So you can't be saying, "Oh, I just like I like transgender." No, you like you like dick,
right? Because what's going on?
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, now I think it's open for question. They're like, okay, so what do y'all do then? All right, because if you like transgender women, and they still got it, they still got the hammer on them. You know what I'm saying? So what is it?
What you're into?
So yeah, what is it? Well, yeah, what do you? Yeah, just man, listen, man.
Don't say gay. Transgender. Just say you're gay.
Listen, and then shit, we don't know what is what anymore because they got so many acronyms and titles and
at all.
You know, listen, man. It's sexual. Your sexual orientation, I don't give a damn about, man. Do what you do.
Do what
I know,
you do.
I know. I do what I do. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, we know.
Yeah. Wow. Shit. I mean, you know what I'm saying? I'm not that, but I'm good though. I'm cool.
What does that mean?
I'm not that, but I'm cool though. That's all I'm saying, bro.
What do you mean? Like you be flirting shit?
No. I mean, what you mean flirting, man? What you mean? Like flirting with guys? What the fuck?
You said I'm not that, but I'm cool.
I'm just cool, bro. All I'm saying is I'm just cool.
Okay.
I'm just cool.
I bet you are.
Yeah, like I'm not gonna sit there and judge you for doing what you do. You do what you do. Get off. Get your shit off. That's how you get off. Get off. Yeah, you know what I mean, okay. So if a gay dude pop at you, what you doing?
Yeah, what am I doing?
What you doing if a gay dude pop at you?
What
is you doing? He was like, hey, what's up?
So fuck you, what's up?
He was like, you just saying what's up? Like, you know what I mean? But he was kind of like flirty with it, like, hey, you know what I mean? Talking about you or something, like, you know what I mean? Just looking at you and like, oh,
they probably
beard.
Get ignored. Go ahead.
You just ignore him?
I just ignore him.
You just ignore him? I would just be like, oh, what's up?
I mean, you gotta shoot your shot.
Yeah, I mean,
they gotta shoot their shot, right?
Listen, man. A person got to shoot their shot, and then a person got to either accept it or decline the offer.
True.
Yeah, right? Now, if I decline the offer and you shoot it again, okay, hold up, bruh. I just told you, we good, but I told you I don't fly that way. I might be fly, but I don't fly that way. You know what I mean? You got to tell them. Because that's fair, right? Even if you got a relationship at work, right? You're in a relationship at work. I'm just saying, you're in a relationship at work, right?
What do you mean, like your woman works there?
No, not your woman. There's your woman, your work wife. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, okay.
All right, so say you got your work wife and shit, or someone that you cool with, right? And then you shoot your shot. But she'd be like, nah, you got to leave that alone. Because you only get one time. You only get one time. Shoot it. Oh, she accepted it. Oh, okay, cool. I'm going to move forward with that. She declined the offer. Okay, cool. You know what? I just thought I would check. I thought it was cool. You know what I mean? You got a fat ass, but hey, it's good. I'm gonna find another one. I'm gonna find another one. Yeah,
I'm lost. Yeah, yeah, all right.
Yeah,
this
so
by my work wife.
Yeah,
right.
There yeah, it is, good. Work wife and all kind of shit, man. All right, man. Let's move ahead to your boy Kyrie Irving, man. Taking a stand, man, against getting the COVID vaccine. He says that he's doing this. Because there's the voiceless, so he's speaking out, being a voice for the voiceless. What say you?
Kyrie's been in that case for a couple years, so, I mean, motherfucker has issues.
Right,
so he has issues. Like, this is nothing just, he's been a nutcase.
So
like,
you just jump off and just be like, you know what, he's just a nutcase.
He's
just
a nutcase.
Just chop it up to that.
He's a fucking nutcase. He's a distraction.
Right.
He's been like that for years now.
What do the Nets do?
Trade him.
You can't, right? I mean, look at his value right now.
I don't care. I'll trade him for whatever right now at this point. I mean, it's your value. It is what it is. Because to me, he's being selfish.
Right.
End of the day, you don't want to do certain things.
Right.
But if we're a fucking team.
Yeah.
And you know, we got like a legitimate shot at a title and we need you.
Okay.
And you can't go get this shot.
Okay.
That you probably been getting vaccinated your whole life with different things.
Let me play devil's advocate now, right? But he's saying, look, man. My body, man, my choice.
True.
Right? My body, my choice. You can't, you know what I'm saying? I don't want that. I don't care what that is. It's just my body, my choice. I don't,
right.
You know, don't force me to take this. I'm not about to be forced to take it. No. You know, so where do you stand on that?
He has fucking issues. What do you mean? You know what I'm saying?
So,
like I said, it's deeper than that. It's deeper than about yourself. It's some prima donna shit, really, that he's doing.
Okay.
Because, nigga, we're a fucking team, bro. We right here. We can't run the pod unless I go get vaccinated. At the end of the day, you got to care about the team or you care about yourself.
Okay.
If you're all in, you're not all in. So since you're not all in, you got to go.
All right. Let me say this, right? Because I agree with some of the stuff that you're saying. I just think that Kyrie is one of those dudes, man, that's try to act like, like smarter than what he is. Like
true.
He wants to be, you know what I'm saying? He wants to be one of those. Yeah, exactly. Like, he just want to be those dudes. He just want to be the dude that, you know, shit, the earth is flat. Right. And he went on. It's like, bro, now that to me, you want attention. You want to sound smarter than what you really are or actually are. And it's like, bro, like, come on, man. Like, come on. And then, and like, think about this, dude. Half of the fucking food we eat, you don't know what's in that food.
True.
You know what I'm saying? Half of the fucking
shit. I get it. Some people are against it. I don't care if you're against it or not.
Yeah.
In his particular situation, in your profession.
That type of profession, yeah.
And first of all, let's not put it, you're missing like $18 million, something crazy. And you're sitting here saying, I don't want to miss money. Yeah, no, you do.
You're going to, if you.
You even try to get a fake vaccination card. Like, what is going on? You didn't try anything.
The fake vaccination, you know the hockey player do.
Yeah, try something, right? Hey, you know what I mean? If everybody done went through it, you the only motherfucker in the NBA that has not done it. Come on,
right? Bro. But here's where I stand at on all of that. Like I'm with you. I'm with it. You know, vax, no vax. I believe it is your choice. But here's the thing: they are giving you a choice.
They are
vax or play, or no vax, no play.
Right
there it is. Those are your choices. So it's not like they're forcing it. You got your choices. This is what it is. Do it or not. Make a choice. Oh, you want to? Okay, cool. Then you're not, because we're not paying no half. We're not doing all road game bullshit. No. What if it come down to game 7 at home? Oh, you can't play. Man, fuck all of that.
So you're going to miss all the home games, the 2 games against the Knicks.
Right.
You're missing all the California stops.
Yeah, because because we got a rule here, out here in
Cali.
So
you're only able to play, what, in Texas and Florida and Arizona? Come on, dude.
We're not doing this. You know, part-time players, man. No,
so I agree with the Nets, and they all agree. Like, he shouldn't just play at all.
Yeah.
So it's just
I agree with you. No, there's a basketball down there, too.
Kyrie wants attention, dude. Like, he's one of them attention motherfuckers, man.
Yeah, I think so,
too. You know, he, like, turned Muslim last year, too?
Oh, okay.
He's Muslim now. He's new Muslim.
But to give Kyrie some credit, I'll give him credit on this, man, because he does a lot of shit off the court. I mean, he does a lot of dumb shit off the court, but he does a lot of good shit off the court, too.
No, he does a lot of charity shit.
He bought George Floyd's, I think, family a house. And he's done some shit.
Yeah,
he need
to recoup that money, nigga. What are you talking about?
Or just own the house.
Own the house. Charging rent. That's all it did. No, y'all can live here, but y'all got to pay rent.
That's fucked up. But no, so he does some good shit, so I want to give him some credit.
He had went, since he's been newfound Muslim, he goes to the Middle East, right? And
okay.
I don't know where he was at. I don't want to say direct country. I really don't know. But it was a Muslim country. He went and, like, he spent a bunch of money on food and water and whatnot and supplies. I mean, like I said, man, he does a lot of things. But it's like, nigga, either you're going to be a basketball player or you're going to be a humanitarian. What are you going
to
do?
I think you can do both. But when it's time to ball, you got to ball.
Exactly. So you're being a humanitarian right now.
Yeah, right. So here's the thing, right, too. My thing is, do you think he loves basketball?
No.
He just plays, huh? He just have fun. He's good at it. But like, you don't love it. You don't got that killer. You know what I mean? That, like.
But it's been like that. He even said he's not going to play until he's late 30s. He said he's going to be done in early 30s.
Yeah, that's a dude that don't love it, man. And it's a team, you know, in a team game, too, bro. Like, we count on each other.
At the end of the day, you can't recoup none of that money back. I don't care if you make $100 million. You still cannot get $18, $20 million back that you forfeit.
No, that's real talk.
Ben Simmons, you don't show up. You forfeit $1 million.
That's going to be the next topic.
You know what I mean? Ben, like, so you can't sit here and. You never get that money back.
Yeah. No, that's a wrap, bro.
That's a wrap. That's if I was Ben Simmons, bro. I'd have fought Doc Rivers already. That's what it would have been.
Here's my
take. You going to throw me out of practice because I don't want to participate?
Man, nah, fuck that, man. Ben Simmons is acting like a little fucking baby, bro.
No, he's not. Yes, he is. No, he's not.
Bro, if I'm Doc, hold on. Well,
let me ask you this.
Wait. No, don't ask me nothing. Let me say this first. Fuck that, bro. The eras, I could tell what era he, I could tell.
Mm-hmm.
Entitlement, coddled. Baby, bro, that's where he come. You could tell, bro. That's weak sauce, man. Look at Giannis. And Giannis can't.
Are you cussing
Giannis,
or not?
Giannis can't fucking shoot a lick. But you know what Giannis do? He'll get up there and shoot that goddamn ball. He'll get on that free throw line, shoot that goddamn free throw, and does not care about what it looks like.
What are we talking about?
Let me tell you what I'm talking about. I'm telling you right now. I'm getting to it.
Are we talking about basketball or what's going on?
No. Listen. Okay, Doc Rivers called you out. Last year. It was about, what is it? Oh, we don't know if we can win with them, right? It's a, bruh, at some point, when do you fucking get some balls and be like, you know what? I'm about to be better. I'm about to work my ass off. I'm about to be better. You do this. You pull this shit. Wait, we paid you, though, too. Like, we paid you like you the man. And then you pull this shit like, oh, I'm not coming to training camp. Oh, I'm not. That's entitlement, bruh. Come on, bruh. That's the fucking difference between my NBA and this NBA. Right?
So if your dad tells you you're not good enough to be his son,
I'm about to do better to be good enough to be his fucking son.
He's trying to trade you to different families. Openly.
Who?
They were trying to trade him all summer.
Because he's pulling this bullshit.
No, this is before the training camp. What are you talking about?
Well, fuck it then. Let's say that is the truth.
That is the truth.
Okay, we're going to just say it is. Okay. I don't believe it.
They were trying to trade him all summer. I know they were trying to trade him.
Okay, yeah, right? I don't mind. Listen. So then he pulled this. This what you doing?
What is he pulling? What is he pulling?
I'm hold out.
Oh, no. This is where he's stupid. I don't give a fuck about the entitlement shit. This is where he's stupid at.
Okay, tell me.
He should pull Deshaun Watson. Oh, I'm going to show up because I got to get paid.
Amen.
Oh, but my hamstring's going to fucking hurt.
But Deshaun Watson didn't do that.
Deshaun Watson wasn't participating in practice either.
No, that's the coaches said don't do nothing. Because
they were trying to trade him too.
But they don't want him to hurt. They don't want him to get hurt.
That nigga wasn't going to participate.
No. That man showed up. And he practiced.
Well, I could throw some drills.
But wait a minute. But that's what I'm saying. That's the ownership saying, hey, don't let him hurt himself though.
If I'm Ben Simmons, this is what's going on. I'm going to show up.
Okay.
And I'm going to be hurt. But I'm going to be there. I don't need to do drills with you because I already know the relationship is fucking tarnished. Until one of you motherfuckers come over here and apologize, it's not just Doc, it's Joel, it's the whole team talking shit. Okay, cool.
Fuck Ben Simmons, man.
Win without me, motherfucker. Win without me. I bet you I don't get far.
Here's the thing.
That's what I would have said. From day one, when I walked in that gym, I'd have said something to Doc. As a man, I said something to Joel. The way he's acting is like a little kid.
He ain't saying the way. No, who acting?
No, the way who? Ben acting is like a little kid.
Okay, thank you. Okay.
I agree with that.
All right.
Because if he wasn't going to participate, A,
there
don't
you go.
Show up.
There you go. Fucking up the thing. Yeah, but
a,
anyway.
Don't show up.
Okay.
Or B, show up. Get your shit off. And nigga, I'm sitting over here so I get paid. Fuck you, Doc. You overrated anyway.
See, my thing is, nah, fuck that, bruh.
I'm not participating in a situation where y'all saying y'all can win without me. Cool, go do that shit. See, you ain't got babysit me, I'll be over here.
Yeah, right, exactly. And I'm glad Joel said that. Like, bro, we ain't got time to babysit nobody. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, go sit. Yeah,
but then
and,
Joel,
and we're
going to summer,
you, and we're going to suspend you because you're at practice with your phone with some sweats on and a fucking, and your phone in your pocket. Bruh, what the fuck? Are we doing this?
So
you still have a job to do, and you still have a contract you signed.
True. You're right about that.
That's all I'm saying. Because they're going to trade you. You know this. We all know this. Bruh, we can't trade you if they're not going to get equal value. We know that. But we can't trade you and get bullshit value because you're acting like this. Man, come in. Do
so
your
this,
work.
This is what they
and
did,
we'll
too,
get
though.
You, we'll get you out of here.
No, this is what they did, too, though.
What did they do?
They wanted, all of a sudden, Joel a couple months ago for training camp. Oh, you know, he's a great piece and trying to big up his value because now his value is diminished. So they're trying to big him up.
Okay, yeah.
Oh, no, he's a great player, a great teammate. No, you know we don't like each other. Why are you in that? Why are you speaking on me?
Right.
I told Joel straight up, like, bro, stop answering questions about me, bro.
Nah, you can't. You can't say
you know
that
what I mean?
To him.
I told him
that. No, but you can't say that to him. But you can't. You know why you can't say that to him? Because you already know the media is going to ask him some questions.
You say no comment.
No, you answer the question. Answer the fucking question. I love when these athletes really answer the question.
Yeah.
I love when coaches really answer the question. I get tired of the coach speak. I get tired of the good teammates speak. No, just hey, man, look, you know it is what it is, man. We're tired of baseball.
If I was Ben, I'd be like, hey, you know that's cool, bro. They said they can win without me. Cool. Let's see.
Listen, man,
I'll be here cheering motherfuckers on. Cool. I'll be the highest paid cheerleader. They would not like me.
Listen, man.
But also, he lost like $1.2 million, something like
that. Yeah, because you're trying to sit out, man, bro. Get out of here with that bullshit.
I just came.
Hey, do your work. Come in. Do your work. We're going to get you out of here, but you got to come. Listen, if all the league knows we're trying to move you, your value is down.
Correct.
Right? So we're not moving you until your value's up, until we can get something. So come in. Ball, we'll move you at the fucking break.
I'm not playing.
We'll move. See, well, go up here. Well, here you are.
Yeah.
Here you. Well, here you are. 125, whatever a million.
Paid, sitting
your ass on. Yeah.
Look, y'all okay, watch what the hell y'all say then.
Yeah, man. Just you know what? That's the difference, man. That's why I like. That's why I like how Giannis fucking handles some of this shit.
We're not talking about.
No, because no. The reason why I bring up Giannis because man, it's. Here's the thing. Ben Simmons don't want to be. He don't want to embarrass himself. That's why he didn't take no shot.
No, exactly.
Wait.
I'm not talking about his play.
I know, but I am. He don't. That's the part that pisses me off.
What pisses you off?
That part that he don't want to go. Fucking
no, his play. You're absolutely fucking right.
And that's why. And that's why we're here. It's because of his play. It's because I don't want to shoot.
So
no, in like the fourth quarter, because I don't want to be. I don't want to get blamed.
Let's keep it 100.
All right,
Doc. If Doc don't come out and say, "Oh, I don't know if he could be a point guard on championship team," if Joel don't bash him in the news, is his value? His value is not as diminished as it was. Which you all saying, "Oh, hey, we gotta get this dude out of here," because that's what you're telling everybody. We gotta get this dude out of here. Yeah. If y'all ain't seen air the motherfucker out, I mean, like, you know, we're gonna work on some shit. Woo-woo, and then try to trade him.
What? You right? You right.
So that'd have been different. I mean,
different.
I think that's
have been different.
That's a collective team fuck up.
Yeah, that'd have been different. You right. You right. That'd have been fucking different. But fuck, man, goddamn, bring your ass in and work, bro.
I'd have came and been hurt.
Bring your ass in and work, man. That's all I'm saying. Shit, because we can move you. We can move you better when we got a little bit of value, and you and we'll probably try to send you. Give us a couple teams that you think, you know what I'm saying, you want to go to. We might even do you a solid that way. But if you don't come in, you come in with this bullshit, bro. It's okay. All right. Well, we both gonna be too miserable.
No, yeah, I guess that's what we're gonna be. y'all wanna talk shit about me in all summer?
We both gonna be miserable in this motherfucker. Man. Fuck it, man.
And when y'all get off to that 2-8 start. And be asking me to play? No, I'm cool.
Yeah, well, it is what it is.
Unless you want to apologize publicly.
Man, fuck all that. All I know is this. They're not going to be as good without him. We know that.
We know that. You know, they know that.
Yeah, they know that too.
So they couldn't get off.
They know that too. I think the best possible thing they could probably do is go grab some, trade them for some reserves, man, some cool little solid players, and just move on from it.
They said move for CJ McCollum.
Yeah, but if I'm Dame, I'm like, God damn, man, this motherfucker don't be scoring. Shit.
Dame need to get the fuck out of Portland.
That's going to be fucked up, bro, because he's going to have to. But I don't see – you know what, to be honest, I love Dame's game. I just don't see him, like, he needs help, bro.
And they have done nothing to change that roster.
But, yeah, but well, how tall is Dame, like 6?
Dame like 6'2", maybe 6'3".
Yeah, 6'2", 6'3", and it's like – I don't know. He just needs some help. McCullough is like cool. Like McCullough is more like a
me and my boy talk about this all the time. You're not gonna win a championship with both y'all being 6'2" guards.
Yeah, and it's I think there it is. Yeah, and I just that's what I'm saying. It's like he just needs
both y'all suspect as fuck on defensive end, and but, you guys are just straight scores. I mean, you guys are the poor version and the smaller version of Steph and us and Clay.
Yeah. I guess so. Anyway, well, shit, man. You got anything else, man? Shit. What else been going on? Fuck. Huh. What else been going on? Shit, man. It's been a while, man. It's been a while. So we here, though.
Did you vote against Newsom?
I didn't vote.
Why?
Because I already knew he was going to win.
But you didn't want him in office.
No, because, you know, you already know why. You know what I'm saying? Like, you fuck with my money. Fuck with my pockets. Then we got a problem. You know what I'm saying? I vote with my pockets. Sometimes I vote morally. Sometimes I don't. You know what I'm saying?
You should have voted. Your vote count, dude.
No, it did. Crazy. It did. Because he won anyway. You know what? I told a lot of motherfuckers this. I said, hey, look, man. This is a state full of Democrats. I said, if half of them come out, he wins. I said, this is a numbers game.
I think so many people would be like, oh, I'm a Democrat. So I got to vote for him. He could be totally going against what the fuck you believe
in, exactly.
Just because he says he is Democrat.
But that's why I'm tired. I'm so tired of this political bullshit because I need to see more people. Just stop going with who your party go. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Like, just be open minded to be like, you know what? Nah, that dude, that's weak sauce. This dude right here, I like what some of the shit he's talking about doing. Do that, but you don't never see that.
So
no
Newsom
more.
Calmed down for them 4 or 5 months. He thought he's gonna get impeached or whatever.
Yeah.
Now he's showing his ass. Little kids got to get the vaccine. Everything.
Again, listen. I'm gonna go out and say I'm vaccinated, but I still believe people should have a choice. Right. I just still people like let people have their choice. Let them do what they want. That's just my opinion on the matter. Do what you want. Don't force motherfucker. And I think you can sell it better if you don't fucking force it.
Exactly. You forcing shit.
I'm good. That's going to make me impotent.
So,
I'm cool.
So you see
bro.
Like what's going on with like the major corporations, like Kaiser lost like 2,000 employees because people wouldn't get vaccinated.
Damn.
Lost like 2,000. Southwest, they're on strike and whatnot.
Southwest, man. Fuck you, Southwest, man. Y'all fucked up my little birthday weekend. I was supposed to go to the Raider game, man. Y'all fucked up my whole flight. Fucked up the whole shit. I had to cancel all my shit, man.
Where are you staying at?
I was Hey, what was that one shit I was going to though for the trap? What was that place?
Travelodge.
No, yeah, Travelodge. No, I was staying there, bro. I stepped up, bro. I thought, you know where I stayed last time? Okay. When I went to the opener, yeah. I stayed at What's the hood one?
Cheshire?
Yeah. Stay there. Yeah, stay there. And then this time,
nigga,
I said,
Central.
Right. And this time I said, you know what? I said, man, I got a little. I could. You know what I mean? I could pay for this. I said, let me go ahead and book my thing for the Luxor. Right. I was juiced, bro. I paid it all up. I'm feeling good about myself. Motherfucker, Southwest was like, flights canceled. Then they hit me up, was like, oh, we could fly you out tomorrow at like 9 p.m. I said, the game's over. You're not flying me anywhere. Don't rebook me. Just, you know what? Let's just go ahead. I'm going to just take the L on this. I'm going to sell my ticket. I'm going to go ahead and reschedule. Nah, just thank you, though, but no thank you. Fucked up. I was even considering driving. I was like, man, I don't want to do it. That's 7 hours. I don't want to do it. I said, fuck, dude. So I didn't do it. So nah, man, Southwest, man, get your shit right, man. Fuck, just wear a mask, man. Let people wear a mask. Stop trying to force this shit on people. Just let them wear a mask.
Southwest, and I believe America, I'm not sure, but they're the last two airlines to enforce the mandate on the vaccine.
Boys. Yeah, yeah.
So if y'all did when everyone else did, it wouldn't have been a big deal.
Right.
Okay. So their headquarters in Dallas is in Texas. Texas ruled with them that it's not mandated. So now is it people that you register in California, you gotta get it? Like,
but how do you work that? How do you work that? I don't know how you fucking work that, man. Fuck that shit, man. It's fucked up. You fucked up my little birthday weekend flight thing, so it is what it is.
All the pilots were on strike.
Huh? The pilots, they said it. First they weren't even saying it wasn't even the vaccine.
They said it was like
traffic controllers. And I said, bro, y'all is full of shit. This is about this vaccine. These motherfuckers said, nah, bro. You got a lot of these motherfuckers getting stranded and shit. That's fucked up. Yeah, I would have been straight out of Vegas.
Yeah, staying out there two more nights.
You know what I mean?
You got it, though.
Yeah, I do what I do. I do what I do. Anyway, man, shit. You got anything? I don't got anything else, man. I don't even know what else is cracking, man. Shit.
Nah, man, go Cowboys, man. We got a bye week this week.
All right, we got the Eagles this week. I think we can handle them.
Jalen Hurts about to have a look. He's back at Alabama.
Nah, he going to be doing what he's doing, fucking shit up.
It's that coordinator.
You think it's a coordinator?
This motherfucker forgot he has Miles Sanders. He runs the ball 5 times a game.
Well, you know, a lot of people, I don't know why people try to get away from the run anyway. I always feel like you should run the ball, but that's just me.
The funniest thing, let me tell you real quick before we go off. I'll say this on here. So, I don't know. Is it just me? So you've been playing Madden this year, right?
Yeah.
So, has a lot of motherfuckers been messaging you?
Yeah, no, they'll hit you up.
Oh, no. Yeah, I like they always hit you up. But I feel like every time this motherfucker's messaging me.
What they saying?
Either good game or we'll say I lose or something. Like talking crazy, like whatever case may be.
Yeah.
Man, this one dude, right, I'm winning. He paused the game.
Yeah.
Just to message me.
Hey, what'd he say?
Call me a coon. Right? And I'm like a coon. Right? Because if you don't know, I know all racial fucking terms, right?
Oh, yeah.
That old 1920 thing you just said, I was like, cool. I was like, what the hell?
I've not heard that in a long time.
I was just like
they
what?
They still use that?
I'm like, a coon. So then I end up winning, and then I say, yeah, this coon just beat you or something.
Yeah.
And we go back and forth, say, yeah, whatever. I'd rather lose than be a coon or something.
Like, and no, said, bro, but you're on Madden trying to beat me, though.
And I told him, he said, then he's brought up, he said, that's why you voted for Joe Biden. I said, what are you talking about? Somebody, I said, I'm a Republican now.
Yeah.
He said, you're a Republican now. Can you see how fucked up Biden is? He said, but you voted last year for Biden. I'm arguing with this motherfucker about politics. I don't even know him.
No. And it's like, come on, man. It's a video game.
I swear,
all this from a video game, bro. Let me tell you something, man. I got hammered out. Man, I was getting hammered out by a dude, man. They be talking mad shit, right?
Right.
You know what I responded with?
Right.
I hit him with the scoreboard, and I'm getting blown. And I'm like, scoreboard. Because they talking shit. Hey, man, you need to quit, man. Turn the game off, man. Turn the game back in. I'm like, scoreboard. And I still be playing. I don't even give up. I'm like, no, keep playing. I'm going to piss your ass off. That's what I do sometimes.
This other motherfucker hit me up talking about, do I have a son that play for the Chargers? I ran with the Chargers.
Yeah.
He said, you got a son that play for the Chargers? I'm like, yeah, how do you know?
Oh, because your name won't lie to
you? I don't know what it is. He's just like, oh, yeah. My son played for them too. He said, yeah, I think we follow each other on Instagram. I said, for real, bro? I said, what's your name?
Yeah.
He told me his Instagram name. This motherfucker's like 48. He's a DJ.
Okay.
And some other shit. I was just like, this dude's a weirdo, right?
Yeah.
So I stopped responding. He keeps hitting me up.
Oh.
I'm allowed to block him.
Damn, you got a little stalker.
He's like, nah, man. He said something like, his son went to Temple. He been following my son, like, for what? Like, so who the fuck is my son?
Nah, he must know you like feet.
Nah.
Yeah, man. he must have heard you on the pod. Shout he must have heard you on the pod, baby.
Shout out to the Foot Nation still, man. Hey, tag them.
Shout out, man, to the feet fetish.
Feet, you know, fetish.
Man. That's what it was. He was like, that's that dude.
So you suck his toes?
Dude. Nah, man, toes ain't my thing.
Bro. Toes ain't your thing?
Nah, toes ain't my thing, man.
So if she was into that, would you do it?
I would do it if she wanted me to, yes.
So you're not into it?
I'm not into it, but I'll do it if she wanted me to.
So you're not a missionary and you just like start sucking her feet, start sucking her toes.
I'll lick her calf.
That's a toe.
I know, calf. But I'm just telling you how close I get, because you know how you get the legs up and shit. Well, I just lick your calf and shit because it's right here by my face. I'll lick your calf.
So you're not licking her feet?
No.
Why?
My wife don't like, she don't want me touching her feet at all. She don't like that shit. She don't like that feet shit at all.
So you never had toes sucked in your life?
I've done it. Yeah, I have my feet licked.
Your feet sucked too?
Yeah.
Oh, did you?
It's just something. I think it's more of
the surprise.
Just the actual, they're sucking my toe. You like, know, you get what I'm saying?
It's more like.
I think you got to start from the little and then go to the.
So that's what happened.
Yeah, I think so. Or she might have just did the little tongue thing. Don't worry about who did that, bro. Why do we go? Okay, since we go do that, then let's play this game. Let's play this game. Shit.
I've never got my toes.
Oh, okay.
So,
now
yeah.
You never. Oh, okay.
Never got my toes.
Okay, all right. All right. Okay. Cool. Because I was gonna be like, who? And I'm gonna start asking who and give me names, addresses, places. Let's not play that game.
You know, I know how you're acting like this.
Let's just talk about our experience. Let's talk about our experiences.
I know how you're acting like this.
Why?
I'll tell you off.
Off camera. We're gonna do that off
camera. I'll tell you off.
All right, man. Well, shit. That's the show, y'all. Season 2, episode 23 or
we gotta go
season two, whatever.
23. Michael Jordan.
Yeah, you already know. I mean, that. Who else? I mean, all the because LeBron followed 23. Like, who else, bro? 23. There's got to be a running back that had 23.
I'm trying to think.
There had to be a corner somewhere that 23. They didn't really make, like, football didn't really make 23 like the hot number.
No, it didn't.
You know what I'm saying? Football don't, but basketball definitely.
Everybody's running 23.
Everybody, yeah. So it's like, we already know. We already know.
I can't even think of football right now.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Every 23 that I can remember is like always been a role player. So I kind of like it's been a while, and I forget who they are. You know what I'm saying? But I remember. Oh, he wore 23, but he was just like, he was in the league for like 2 or 3 years, and that was it. But yeah, man, I don't know, man. Shit. Anyway, all right. Again, that's it. Support the Homie Podcast, episode 23 is in
like,
the books.
Subscribe.
You know what I mean?
Like, subscribe.
Yeah, all
that.
Man, comment and all this shit, man. And we'll holler at y'all next week. We out.